we've got our Saturday footage to go over. By the looks of it, it was pretty active, at least in the beginning. So let's see what we got. Okay. Got Daniel here with Veronica right off the bat. Levi over there trying to break Cooper's arm. Hits a standing guard break. Okay, cool. Thank you, James. Cole hitting a straight arm, so don't really know how he got there, but we'll give him his credit for that. Aries throwing up some sort of triangle attack here. Who's he going with? So we're looking under the... Oh, he's with Tony. Okay. So looking here, Tony back on the mats. Aries coming around from side control. I don't know if he has the leg in this, but if he does, he's got himself in a reverse triangle, which is definitely the tightest triangle of the five typical ones that you run into, as well as digging on an arm. I don't know if he has an immediate arm attack on this just yet. He might be able to work up to a Kimura, but I would focus on the leg position there. Tony does well to get out of that, though. Can you guys hear me okay? Looks like my levels are... All right. Yeah, looks good. Sorry, I just want to see... What's Ronnie doing? Ronnie gets up on top here. Okay, because Daniel goes for an armbar. Okay, Daniel gets the armbar. Got it. And I really like to see this. This is some good additions to Jordan's passing approach. Looks like he was working a lot of the stuff that we went over from like open guard and half guard and all that. So happy to see that. James joining the fray. With Ben. Ben had an opportunity to wrestle up there. Daniel hitting a banana split on Ronnie. I don't think I've ever seen anybody try to banana split Ronnie. How does he? So he gets there. Coming up over the back. Rather than breaking down the turtle with like a power half, instead he goes down to the legs. Ronnie's like, yeah, go for it. And he uses it instead just to get a pass. Nick shutting down Danny's attempt to run to the back. But now in a little bit of trouble, well, briefly, as Danny was digging on his leg but didn't quite get there. Anybody train today? James, were you up there? You might be the only one in chat. Oh, what's up? I see Andrew there. Nick. Hey, Cole, your name didn't pop up in the viewers. So maybe speak up next time, dude. How was training today? Whoever trained. I mean, I like that Jordan is doing that. See him climb that wall. Oh, he's barely even touching the wall. Get out of here. You're just mad because you're stuck under him. Yeah. Tripodding up. Oh, there it is. Okay. Yeah, all right. I'd be mad too if I was you. But I like that he did it. That was nice. And we got Nick here. Nice big step over into mount. Looks like he's working off of that. I don't know if that was like a Kimura attack or just like a one-handed Kimura grip he had on Danny there. But that opens up the mount for him as Danny goes to turn and get his arm safe. Nick looks to take the back, but can't beat Danny as he goes for that chair sit. Kind of the importance of that chair sit is, you know, one, locking up that gift wrap so that Danny can't turn with this. I mean, because I don't think... Yeah, I mean, like, there's no real... There's no grip here that Nick is using that would prevent Danny from turning within the legs. That's the utility of the gift wrap or arm wrap in this position. So now Danny can just kind of pretty leisurely, you know, address the long hook that's here. His arm's not in a terrible spot because his head is over that leg. And he's driving off of the mat with this foot to keep his body going in this direction. So it's going to be hard for Nick to set up the arm bar from there. So Danny just has to kind of roll up and now gets to settle into a pretty easily earned top half guard with Nick flattened out. What am I missing? Am I missing anything, guys? We got Tony over here. Somehow, Ari was giving him the business a little bit ago. Okay, so from that reverse triangle, Tony gets out. We're looking right here. And now Tony's able to kind of smash. He's got Ari's turned up a little bit. Works his way from a three-quarter guard into mount, full mount. And James, what did you do? I hope it had something to do with trying to get to cross Ashi and Ben just takes control, but it looks like that's not the case. Ben, looked like you tried a knee cut there, James, and then Ben was just able to wrestle up. Your knee wasn't like really close to the body or anything. Maybe this was a bit of a gentleman's agreement. You take the bottom, let Ben work. We're way back. Here we go. What's up, Ben? How you doing, buddy? James, be a little bit more respectful, man. At least show some urgency here. Gonna make Ben feel bad. Just wrestled up. Okay. Yeah, I know you know how to knee cut, so it was weird that your knee was in that position, so I wouldn't suspect you to do like a poor knee cut. Is that David we got over here in the corner with is that his son? Let's see if Daniel goes for the rolling back take here. It looks like he's setting up for it. He's got like a body lock grip. Maybe he abandons it. Now he's going over the top. Cole did something. We'll get back to that in a second. What did Cole do? I imagine his sweep. We're never going to get out of this round. Just keep going back to the same spot over and over. Big pendulum with the legs there to initiate just enough movement to get Jordan off balance. Comes up into closed guard. Jordan attempts maybe a triangle or something. Maybe thinking a triangle off the bat. Oh, James locks up a good Kimura here. Ben hides the hand. It gets safe. That was nasty, James. That looked dangerous. So we got Ben pressuring forward from top half. For a split second, leaves his arm out, and James jumps on it. But yeah, Ben, good movement, Ben, to keep your hand tucked and like grabbing your inner thigh and then trying to circle around to... keep him from just yanking it out. Danny's making his way to a triangle. I haven't seen Danny hit a triangle in a while, I feel like, on stream. Correct me if I'm wrong, but definitely been a game of Darces for a long, long time. But Nick gets saved by the bell. Cole ends in mount-ish. Yeah, pretty much. With Jordan recovering position. David getting psyched up to go against Daniel. Cole just about gets a sweep in one direction and then changes the direction there as they hit the ground. Looking for the Sumigeshi, kind of a side Sumigeshi or Yoko Sumigeshi. But then I like that. I like that switch you make there, Cole. Because you don't have that arm at all. You don't have his right arm, but that's the direction you end up going. So as you feel that one failing, you lock up the overhook on that and then take him for a quick switch in the other direction. Good dynamic adjustment there. Danny looking to fight Tony for his rash guard. Another. I just liked the color order. I love when that happens. Let's see, Aries setting up some Uchi here, maybe. I'm like looking to sit out from Bin's back take. And Peter's taking a page out of Steven's book, setting up that Kimura threat with somebody on your back. I should try to work that in more. I like when, you know, you guys get to the back. I like seeing you immediately attacking the grip. Mike is seated here, so it's going to be a little different. But you attack the grip, you hip out, and you try to, like, open the grip up, run out. But again, that's much more of a passive approach, whereas this approach is much more offensive. You can really turn the tide of a match quickly in that case. What did Daniel do to get David down? Did they just go down? Okay, so we got Daniel sets up a little hip toss and then runs through. So that's, yeah, kind of like, I feel like we did something like that recently. Maybe it was more, I think that was more of like an inside trip to an Ouchigari to a Kouchigari, or like a major inside trip to a minor. Kind of similar idea. Aries with a quick snatch single on that leg, runs a pipe, gets Cooper down. He's now crowding that leg into Cooper's hip, so it's going to be hard for him to use that, create some distance. There he goes. He gets out, sets up the body triangle from bottom, which I always hate when people do that to me. Mike breaking shins. Let's see how he gets here. This digging Bin's leg out from bottom half is not easy. So a lot has to go right for Mike here. What's up, Coop? So yeah, a few good points from Mike. So digs in on the leg, but this arm has a very important job to do. It's going to swim underneath between Mike's chest and Bin's chest. And you're going to see his hand poke out of the armpit for this cross shoulder post. Here he's framing, creating a little space. Swims under and gets his cross shoulder post. This is going to take, if it all goes to plan, this is what allows Mike to off balance Bin towards his right leg to make the left leg light and easy to remove out. Again, not always the easiest thing. I think we've all experienced Bin's base is formidable. So See Mike reinforcing that with his knee, really getting Ben's head over the opposite leg. And then he's going to make a switch from this cross shoulder post to grab at the heel or the ankle all the way at the end of the lever. And then locks up his leg configuration by sitting through, hipping in this direction, kind of scooting into that Urimiyashi. And then now he's going with that straight ankle grip. Does a wrist-to-wrist grip here instead of like a gable grip. So a little bit tighter than a gable grip. The other good thing here is from this entry, he's able to crowd Ben's other leg, his free leg or secondary leg, whatever you want to call it. He's kind of weighing on it and crowding it so that it's going to be very difficult for Ben to use it to escape or, you know, make it, he's making it difficult for him to stand up on it, which is going to help him, you know, lighten the pressure of the straight ankle lock. He gets Ben turned in a direction that makes it hard to stand. So good details all around from Mike. This is an interesting takedown from Daniel. So he gets behind David. David stands up. A little step around. David lifts his leg so that he doesn't trip over it or hyperextend his leg. But then now as he goes to recover, Daniel sits through. This is nice. I like this. Sits through, pulls him over, and is in a good spot right past the guard, is able to set up and get to work. Cooper looking at a triangle here on Aries. Good leg configuration. Coop, why did you let that go? My brother. Rides really high. I think Aries pulls his arm out. Yep. Good adjustment, Coop. This is awesome. I don't know why you let this go. I mean, it literally looks like you just open your lock on this one. I don't know if I could give Aries the credit on that, even with this, what this hand does here, where he pushes the hamstring. Maybe you're adjusting, and at the time you're adjusting, he's able to push off. Like, it was just, you know, good timing, inadvertently on Aries' part. But now, yeah, he gets to turn the corner, turn this into a heavy pass. Maybe not. Oh no, he's got both arms out now. Yeah, you don't have an arm in here, bud, so it's going to be more control than anything, but he's got your legs locked up. Either way, Coop, that looked good, man. I would have liked to have seen you finish that. I think you had everything you needed there. Remember, I always tell you guys, especially with guillotines and stuff, trust the choke. Do it with your darces, whatever. Do it with your triangles, too. Your legs are so much more powerful than your arms are going to be, so when you get a good triangle locked up, give it time to work. Give it time to work. Just wait. Don't tell me what to do. Put you in timeout, child. Mike on a Kimura over there. Let's see if Daniel takes David down from this body lock. He's got double overhooks. David conceding, going down to a knee. Coop taking the back. Locks up the body triangle. Aries going high with two arms here. Good switch of the body triangle. If you don't like that lock on the bottom side, I don't. I like to switch when people put me there. Just gives them an opportunity to escape, but whatever. I'd rather deal with that than uncomfortable ankles. Daniel do. Daniel laying on some pressure. This sucks. This hurts my... when this happens to me, it really just hurts my pec more than anything. Like, that David's arm is crossed up across his body. I wonder if we can catch the moment it happens. And then Daniel just gets behind the tricep. So now David can't get the arm back across. I mean, I'm not going to say Daniel's doing anything wrong here. He obviously gets a tap. Another way you'll often see this finished is like if Daniel slid his knee up the body, almost like he's sitting to Kesa. That really sucks. Kind of turns into a compression choke. Jordan and I having a big kid match. Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Oh, I see you. I saw you here a second ago. Laying on pressure, looking like you're trying to get around. Jordan tries to sit through back to guard. Ben staving off that Kimura very well for Mike. Mike just about gets to the back, though. See, James, you're on a guillotine threat now, it looks like. I don't think you have an arm in, so that's pretty nasty. But, good move from Jordan, getting you to the side and hopping over on that to try to stay safe. Now he's pretty extended, tripoding up really high. Let's see if you could flip him here. That's kind of what I have a feeling is going to happen, but maybe not. Nope. He just settles right in a mount with the elbow above your shoulder line. Looking here. Damn, dude. That was like a well-timed off-balancing. The danger of that, that's you're doing that shoulder push, which I really love from side control. I'm always weary about seeing you guys do it from mount, just because it's kind of breaking one of those rules. You're not really pushing on the chest like we tell you guys not to do when you're white belts. But you get Jordan off-balance enough here that his right leg is really light enough, so you can go out the back. Out the back side door, if you will. High risk, high reward, right? Cooper, what did you do? Did you finish that, bud? Oh, snap. Okay. Coop says, I got some party tricks. Switches down to the kind of a high ball ride with the body triangle. Sits up, says, I don't need your neck. Coop, making James proud here, I bet. Dude, making me proud. That was really nice, man. See if there's any tips I can give you on this. Some things, so this isn't something to necessarily change, something you could try. So you take a scoop on the leg here. Another thing I like to do is hug over the leg. So see how Aries' heel is kind of close to his butt, like it's, you know, his knee is bent. You can hug over his entire shin, right? So you're not going under the leg and hooking, you're just hugging over that shin. Give yourself a good elbow to elbow grip over his entire leg. It's going to be really hard for him to extend his leg when his knee is that bent. So you'll see that as another common finish. Again, you don't have to do that. I'm not going to say you're like risking anything by taking the scoop grip. And then just make sure you are digging your heels to the ground once you get here. We always tend, whenever we have a grip on something, we always tend to use our hands to like finish the move, right? Your legs are an integral part of this. So make sure, I just can't see if you're doing it or not. That's why I'm saying this. Make sure you're just digging your heels down into the mat. Let your arms keep his leg pinned where it is. His leg isn't going to go any further, but pin your heels to the mat to make sure you're getting the most out of this. But either way, man, super nice. I love that you've added that into your arsenal. I don't know any other 16-year-olds doing banana splits in jiu-jitsu. Maybe some 10th Planet kiddos, but we don't see them too much around our parts. In on a single leg yourself now. Aries keeping it to the outside, being defensive with it. Gets it back. Nice. Taking that single leg up high. A little trip behind. Oh. Did you get caught? Looks like you're getting caught. Aries is adjusting to a good knee position, but does not get the finish with that. James looking for looking for a Kimura there. And Jordan dives through right at the bell to enter the legs. This was interesting. So big step over. I don't know, James, you know better than me. Is Jordan looking for a toe hold here, or was he maybe looking for a knee bar by spinning the leg? It's hard to tell. It looked like he had knee bar. Okay. Couldn't tell. It looked like his grip was maybe more for the toe hold, but definitely body position better for a knee bar. Goodness gracious, we're two rounds in, 30 minutes into this stream. I talk way too much. Let's see, Ronnie with Nick. Got Coop. That banana split was sick. I want to see you hitting those more. I want to see you hit one on Ronnie. Just like Daniel tried to do. All right, David and Cole. Tony and Daniel. Nick looking for a little overback position, maybe. Goes Kimura instead. Ronnie is no stranger to those. What's up, Ronnie? Who, Daniel? Yeah, it looked like Daniel tried and maybe succeeded. I mean, not, you know, figuratively murdering you. Mike's on his Kimura game today. Really making Danny work here. That's a fun little scramble for those two. When did he get that? So Mike sets up his Kimura. Is looking, so he's really trying to get his legs underneath Danny to, like, I think actually get the Kimura here. And then he decides to quickly change, go the opposite direction right here. Walks the other way. Comes up over the back. So the only thing I'm, like, seeing the way Mike's body ends up here, the one thing I feel like is missing from the Kimura is pushing the hands through Danny's chest on that, from that Kimura trap, which is a really crucial part to getting their back if you don't want to climb the back. I don't know if Mike's doing that purposefully or not, but Danny rips the arm out, and Mike wastes no time coming up on an attempt at the single leg. Danny flips him, but Mike settles into top position. So technically, I'd say Mike gets a sweep there. But he still has a long way to go getting around Danny's guard. So Ronnie makes her way past Nick's guard here. Or at least flattens him back out. I think she was already past his guard, and he was trying to sit up with that over back grip. Yeah, Ronnie, that was really hilarious to see Daniel trying to banana split you. I don't think I've ever seen anybody try to hit a banana split on you. That's funny. Okay, I got you. What a Colesif do here. Cole working to the belly down rear naked strangle and gets it. Doesn't run off the mat and get his piece of paper, though, to announce to the world that he called a shot. So Tony trying to make his way past that top half guard. He's got to get his knee free. It's where we like to see the foot wedge getting put into use. But Daniel gets tired of waiting and takes the sweep, ending up in close guard. Ronnie has that far side arm extended and vulnerable, but Nick is doing everything he can to get that knee elbow connection, gets his bottom knee back in. It can now work from a bottom half guard with no elbow post or anything like that. Now he's getting a little bit safer. Cole's going to throw David here. Big turn, I bet. Calling it. not as big, but big enough. Escape, no splits. Had a good opening a few times. Couldn't finish it. Got you. What did Daniel do here? Oh, looks like they just reset off the wall. Okay. Ronnie, I assume, just talking smack. She's not being very active right now. Towards somebody, probably Cole. What's Cole get? Okay, straight arm from Cole. So dismounting once he's got that arm extended, but walking up to that shoulder line. What I like about that is you guys always learn Americanas and straight arms, you know, at the very beginning from that mount position. But what ends up happening is your opponent just turns towards that arm eventually when they start to get their, you know, defensive prowess built up. And it takes that away. Yeah, we then learn to maybe take the back with a chair sit and all that. But you can always revisit that Americana after, if you're like me, after you long ago stopped doing it and say, well, wait a minute. What if I stop them from turning by just going to like a mounted crucifix position or shin pinning that arm? Then they can't turn, and I could all of a sudden Americanas are useful again for submissions, not just for opening up the back. So I prefer it from half guard. Are you talking about the Americana, Ronnie, or the straight arm? If so, yeah, I could see that. That makes sense. I mean, the difference between that and what I'm saying is. The level, or is which half of the body you're preventing the turn on, but it makes sense the outcome would be the same. If their hips can't turn, they may have a harder time getting that arm across. If their arm is pinned to the mat, then they definitely won't be able to go. So yeah, I feel like the outcome could be the same. I feel like I have a better hip pin. That's because you do have a good hip pin. I hate your hip pin. But yeah, no, that makes sense. I like that detail. I hadn't considered that. Let's see. David attacking Cole's right arm, maybe. Cole just had surgery on that right arm like 3 years ago. So I'm going to say Cole tapped there. I don't know if Cole's still in the chat, but we'll just say he tapped. David tapped Cole. You know why I never thought about that, Ronnie, is because I am too short to really pin effectively from that top half guard and work diagonally up the body to a good figure four grip on that Americana. I don't think I'm either too short to do that, or I've never considered giving myself the opportunity to try that. Thank you, Coop. Thank you. Very insightful comment. Kid hits one banana split. Thinks he's hot shit now. I'm going to grapple you next time I see you, and I'm only going to banana split you for the entire round. Same with the foot hooks on the thighs. In what position are you talking about? James being real heavy on the head here. Bullying Cole to the mat. Cole says, I don't want any more. Oh, yeah. I think, weren't we talking about that like a week or two ago? I think I know what you're talking about. Let's see. James crowding in on that bottom leg. A little leg riding here, making it difficult for Cole to turn back and get his guard into a better place. Oh, but he's got his patented grip moving to a shoulder crunch. That was a really good shoulder crunch from Cole. James trying to keep that lock. Ben making his way around Aries' guard here. Aries looking to go fishing with that near side leg. It's a It's a side control escape I actually really like to do. I don't know if I could do it anymore though, at least on that side. Let's see if James can get a sweep out of this. Man, if you could like, if you could get that right knee through and work to like a shin to shin position, you might be able to get Cole pretty off balance here. The danger here for James is Cole moving to a mounted triangle, possibly. Cole laying on the shoulder pressure, though. I mean, James, that was good. good defense on shutting down his arm lock. He was going for her immediately. Nice, man. That was a great escape. I mean, everything about this whole scramble is really nice. See this shoulder crunch again. So goes head and arm. James slips the head. Cole says, I'll keep the arm. Good elbow position over the shoulder blade. Good extension. Good step over right into mount, wasting no time, getting caught in half guard. And then James throwing on that S grip to defend until he can get to a position where he gets Cole off balance enough to slip out the back. Let's go with that grip so that he could turn and then makes his way out the back. That was interesting. Putting the ankles over the head and then jumping through. I mean, it makes sense, right? As Cole fights to get his legs and his lower back down to the mat, you bring your legs in close and just kind of double knee cut right up across. Can't say I've ever seen that. That was slick. Been on a dorsal kimura here against Aries. Just about digging for the grip. Doesn't quite have the arm isolated though. And Aries is going to take that as an opportunity probably to hide his back and maybe turn back to him to get his guard back. This is a great round so far, man. You guys are having a killer match. You got Cole's arm isolated up nice and high. See what he can do to get that arm back. I know eventually he just likes to pull it back and make you think you never did anything to even have it there. But I like you taking your time here, working up by the elbow and then trying to get your head behind it. That's going to be the hardest part. That's the moment that Cole has to try to get his arm back to a safe place. Jordan on cross Ashi here against Tony. Tony coming up, trying to stack into it. Let's see if Jordan can get him back down. Tony's made his way to safety here. Yep. Just want to see how Jordan got there real quick, because I know he's been enjoying this position. Looks like the same entrance we're going to see just to the side of your screen. I think he's going to spin the leg in more of a reverse Ashi. Now he's kind of settling into cross Ashi. Nice. Just take your time with that, Jordan. I want to see you scooping the leg with this hand, not basing with it. And I want to see you getting this knee up across the body and just kind of sitting there. Like, take your time. So this left arm is going to be the one that posts like up by the shoulder line. This arm is going to be scooping the leg and just hang out in that kind of knee on belly or shin on belly position until you can make your turn in a controlled manner. Make sure that, you know, making sure that Tony can't like reach up and grab the head, stacking into you like he does here. That's where this went wrong for you. You got the right idea. Just got to tweak some of those details a bit. I think you'll be able to get to that much more safely and effectively. Cole mocking James right now, trying to make him laugh because nothing else has worked. If you make James laugh, he gets weak, and that's when you can escape. Oh, James got a little one-arm Americana attempt there. Aries on a triangle briefly. to wait for 1 second. Cole trying the Mitchell escape. Good, smooth guard passing. See how important that hand or that elbow and hand position is right here. Hand to the knee to push it by. This hand to Cole's hip. And then head to the far shoulder or close to it to prevent that leg from coming in. Run the 90. And just like that. Gets past the guard. Right at the bell. That was a nice round, man. That was real exciting. Cole and Danny. God, I have to add, there we go. I knew what you were doing. I have to add, Caleb's bleeding broken eye socket face emoji. I think I should have some time this week to do that. Danny and Cole here getting after it. So Cole charging in, gets that pinch headlock grip. Danny though, wisely trying to keep his knees in to get Cole off balance, but his arm is in a little bit of danger here. Cole says, yeah, get back down. It looks like Nick chased down David to the mat. David, I want to see you get that leg free and just switch your hips. So, like, send this leg that way, and then this leg, send it that way. Switch your hips and just rotate out of that. Because Nick doesn't have any real rotational control over you there. Cole gets caught in the darce. We've all been there. From Danny. Danny rolls up on this. Got a deep darce, puts Cole down. Nice. Good counter. Got to be careful with Danny in that position. See little dude getting after it with Ben. Does anybody know this little gentleman's name? I'm admittedly behind on knowing some of the kid students' names. But if they're here rolling with the adults, I should know their names. This Cole and Danny spoiling David and Nick's fun here. Danny had some grapevines there, really splaying out Cole's base. Cole's got the foot in. There we go. He needed to find the knee, and then now he can get those legs separated. Daniel on a straight arm with Jordan here. How did they end up on the ground? Okay, Jordan sits. Daniel gets passed. Goes dorsal Kimura, but then Jordan hides the back. Daniel gets it out. Cole, he gave up the underhook, man. Danny's got this lockdown on you, so he's going to get you off balance here. Thank God. Do you want me to go back so you could see Danny Darsu? Genuine question. Okay. Now you're getting electric chaired. Which Danny uses one as a submission attempt, but failing that, it's a great opportunity to come up on a sweep. The electric chair short-circuited. Cole not having it. Now sets up this head and arm pinch headlock grip. See, Danny's doing real good about just keeping that knee in. Looks like you're trying to beat it there, but he's... That's the only thing saving him right now, but it's an important detail. Now he's out the back. The six of you congregating together, like three Cheerios and a bowl of cereal right at the end, all coming together. How do they get there? How do they know they're there? Doesn't matter. They're just brought together. David having to move again to avoid eating a foot to the face. But Jordan on the attack on Daniel now. His name is Isaac. Okay, cool. Welcome to adult class, Isaac. I don't know if you've been... I don't know if this was his first or not. Of course, I miss it. Got a new kid to beat up on. Danny climbs the body here. It's kind of opts to not knee cut, instead steps over into mount. Daniel just about got Jordan turned there. I know you were, buddy. Meanwhile, James dealing with Ares' half guard. Low knee shield, half guard, smashes the knee shield down, and then taking a page out of Coach Luke's book, which I hate that book, switches to a toe hold like a douchebag. Nice. Good work, James. Another move I never think about doing. I don't know why. It's like it's right there, especially with the low knee shield. I've just totally slept on that move forever. Good thing about that move is when it fails, kind of like we saw Danny with the electric chair, you know, it fails, you get a sweep out of it. With that toe hold on the knee shield leg, they kick out of it and they get rid of their own knee shield, which is half the battle of a half guard. And then James immediately following up with a big, big reap here to an outside heel hook. From that, right? Where you're in cross ashi. Oh yeah, this is more Z-lock. So you've got you pass over from the cross ashi to that inside ashi, as I like to call it, attacking that outside heel hook. Nasty position, man. It still scares me when I see you guys doing it. Even though I trust you to not rip off or blow apart Ares' knee. Danny making his way to high mount, looking for an S mount here. He's gonna have to get Cole's head off the ground. Yeah, that you could tighten that up. You really gotta take your time here. This is my biggest problem from this. Steven has always been my measurement as to whether or not my S mount is good, which means it's not, because he always gets out of it. But picking the head up, and like there are a few details here that'll make or break this position. Gotta pick the head up on this. It's very easy to get off balanced, which is exactly how Cole gets out of this. Yeah, it's tough, man. I'll have to demonstrate that a bit more. It's hard to talk through. Z-lock outside heel hooks. Looks like Gordon's last finish. Gordon's last match was against Josh. What's his last name? It's escaping me now. I can't remember if that was an inside heel hook. I'm sorry, an inside ashi with the outside heel hook or Z-lock. But if it wasn't, another good example of when Gordon did that was against Nicky Rod in ADCC in the weight class, the finals for the weight class. I believe he hits one. James looking to rip Aries' arm off his body, moving to the head scissor. Again, just doing his best Luke impression today. Nice. I'm sorry. David pretty much. Okay, David ends, gets past the legs, hops up into mouth. Cool. Look at that rash guard. It's a sexy rash guard. Hopefully that QR code actually works. That's what I thought. I saw Isaac and David squirreling around over here in the corner. Glad to see he's looking to get even better. Cole still tired, obviously, so we won't hold this against him. But Mike riding real high. So Mike, it looks like a shoulder crunch, but Mike's up north of the shoulder now. Mike's looking to get to an Udigatami or a straight arm lock here, but he's got to get his hips out in the other direction. Cole's going to make this very difficult. So I think Mike is more using this for control, maybe try to turn it back into a shoulder crunch or some sort of sweep. Yeah, that was going to be tough to work back from. Cole was getting to a much better position. Thank you. Yes. Yes, Cole. Yep. Yep, indeed. Mike with the over back grip. Cole's Hitachi grip. And hits Cole with the shoulder crunch, but Cole re-rolls him and keeps him down. Nice reaction, Cole. Not letting Mike settle into that position. That's the best time to reverse that. Oh, and Mike reverses. This time using that figure four grip and pushing through the chest like we were talking about when he hit the Kimura trap. I'm going to let you two work that one out. James, similar entry that we saw Peter said earlier, right? Using that cross shoulder post. Well, I guess not quite the same. Gets the push. You weren't digging on the D-path like Peters was earlier, but similar outcomes. Nice. That was really, really great control. I like how you worked through the grip on the ankle there. You knew what you had with the hip control, so you just had to get the knee pointed in the right direction. Both of you hitting the sweep at the same time. Just about got Mike turned over there. And Mike runs to north-south there, likely to shut down, to take away Cole's ability to hit that sweep attempt on him again, if I had to guess. Just get away from the legs, get to a position where he can't turn you like that. I don't remember any of this. Were you blacked out? Mike Kimura trap's pretty annoyingly effective. Yeah, when Mike gets a Kimura, it's akin to, like, I mean, I don't know, Luke and Bertram too, man. When they get Kimuras, it's gonna be a rough day. The best I can tell you for dealing with a Kimura grip like that is one of two things, depending on how they're oriented. Like, if they're in that T Kimura position where they're kind of, you know, behind you, like they've used the Kimura to like roll past your legs and they're behind you, and you guys are shaped like a T, first easy thing you can do is just try to grab your own fist. If this arm is the one that's controlled, grab your fist and just try to bench press your own arm away. Force your arm straight, and that'll weaken their figure four. Second, I attack the knuckle line. Remember, you can't grab individual fingers or even two or three. Grab the entire knuckle line, like right here, to try to weaken one of the grips, and then try to extend your arm out. It's not even a sure thing, especially with those guys, because their grip is crazy strong. But you know, that might be one of the few things you could do, depending on the position they have you in. Stop training lats so they atrophy and my arms aren't so far away from the body. Yeah, that's a you problem, bud. I don't have any experience to give you for that. Man, Cole doing his own version. We might have to call this like the Gromis escape now. Not quite getting to Mitchell's version of the escape, but I've seen him use that kind of pendulum motion of the legs, or just that big boost of energy. It's almost like an inverted bridge or something. But now he's got Mike turned over all the way into full mount, Mike keeping that grip behind the back to try to stay safe. I feel like you thought you were losing mount there, and your leg adjustment was really nice to try to maintain and lose that at your own, on your own, you know, like on your own terms, rather than getting your left leg caught underneath Mike as he tries to bridge. Keep the legs high and then say, all right, you might lose mount, but I'm going to put you in side control and maybe lay on some heavy pressure. I didn't even see Ronnie and Ben over there. Ronnie looking like she's smashy. Goes for a leg here. Looking for the heel hook. But Ben quick on the turn. Gets the knee free. Now Ben on the attack. When Ben gets past your guard, it's going to be a hard rest of the round. And it looks to be the case here. All right, Daniel and Mike. The heel hook was Josh Saunders. Okay. Josh Saunders. That's who it is. Forgot his last name. You know, I was going to say Accord, Cole. I was going to say that. I was also thinking Volition, but I didn't feel like that word really fit. Nothing exciting. It's okay. Every round with you is exciting, Ronnie. Speaking of exciting, Daniel. Big, big front roll over that neck. He doesn't care. Spry. I can't do that. Maybe I could. I just don't want to. I don't want to try. Mike looking to go over the back, possibly. There it is. He's sitting out for it. Daniel rolling again. Good control over that bottom leg. Negative. It's a good ridge line, bro. Isaac attacking an arm bar here on Coop. Doesn't have the body side leg. And Coop leaning into it, getting that leg off his face, staying safe. Daniel making his way to Mike's back here. Is Daniel losing the back only because he's lost Mike's shoulders? Yeah, he knows what he's got now, so he decides to get up to mount on his own accord, try to regain the position. That sucks. Little spine curl there to get Mike flattened out. Been there. Let's fast forward a bit. Mike manages to escape with an elbow escape. Sucks the knee up through. Daniel turning towards the legs this time, and Mike looking to try that over back escape again. Daniel gets the leg flattened out here and is able to just hop over. Mounted crucifix. Mike in danger. Daniel gets that arm extended. It goes for a wrist lock in the other direction. Mike rolls up, but exposes the back in doing so. Yeah, this sucks. It is Mike's birthday. Ooh, good armbar. Saw Daniel hit that same armbar on Ronnie earlier. I like the finishing details he has here. Once he gets that grip extended, he doesn't take it straight back. He takes it over the head in this direction first. And then once he knows he has the arm under control, he moves to the end of the lever, grabs the wrist and the hand, keeps it under control, and gets it. That's nice. Isaac looking for the rear naked strangle. Can he put Cooper out? Can he shut Cooper up? We've all been unable to do it. If Isaac can do it, there's hope for the rest of us. Aries and David over here, onto the clock. Maybe they're talking takedowns, okay. So Daniel opting to start from the bottom position. Goes deep half on Mike. Let's see if he can get Mike off balance enough. We're gonna see him scissor his legs, most likely try to get his hips higher than Mike's to win this this little scramble here. Mike using a lot of cross-facing pressure a second ago. So you see how Mike's hiking his hips up, trying to put that foot wedge to a better spot. Daniel catches him at a good time. See, kind of, Daniel puts his feelers out here. He says, you know, that knee is awfully close to my body. It's not very far out. Mike doesn't have much of a kickstand out right now. So Daniel feels confident in hitting this bridge. Look at that, blocks the knee, gets the underhook, pressures off the legs, gets the turn, gets his hips up. Same family of sweeps that we see like Jordan and Cole and Joe doing. Just keeping an arm in really close to the body, hitting a turn, going. There we see Daniel using it with the legs. Who is this? Nick and James. Looks like we're going to be focusing on the left side of the screen, or I'm sorry, whatever, right side of the screen under the chat. Armenian sweep. I don't know what to think about that. I think you're making it up. Only Mike and I are allowed to make up stuff on this stream. And it normally is Japanese words. My first round with him, first 5 minutes, 30 seconds were his. I'll be honest, man. I like rolling with Nick, but I feel like he holds back on me a little bit with some of the rolls I've seen him give you guys. Just based on that comment, James, I'm wondering if he's like, there's a... Oh, good one, Cole. I get it. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Arminian sweep. That was clever. I'll give you that. But yeah, I see Nick rolling with you guys, and I'm like, does he just not give me as much pressure, or am I like holding it off good enough? But he brings it, man. See you here if you can get to your over back grip. He's keeping your hips flattened out. It's gonna make it pretty difficult. Yeah, he is. Yeah, that's what he told me. He trained over at ECBJJ over, I think, in Wilmington, I want to say. Yeah, dude, 4 years is that is a good amount of time to become a really strong blue belt. Skill-wise, not even strength-wise, which he also has. All that being said, if Nick comes in and says, "Hey, I saw the stream and you're right, I'm gonna open it up on you now," I think I messed up if that happens. I know plenty of places in Charleston. Thank you for asking, Cooper. Oh, you mean like a jiu-jitsu place? I don't. Unfortunately, I haven't gotten to train out there. All the injuries I've had, I've trained maybe 2 years. Yeah. I mean, and counting, skipping warm-ups and all that stuff, which maybe correlates to your injuries, Cole. Possibly. Nick makes his way to mount here, slaps out. Let's see if James is really hunting for that leg. Report back. Dude, I'm sure there is one out there. I mean, you got a whole bunch of dudes out there for either the military or like the Citadel. And guys like to fight. So someone's probably cashing in on that. I'm not dead, Cole. I'm just injured. But fewer injuries than you because I warm up. Nick almost has that back take. Close that gap up a little bit before you do it. And then yeah, this is the other key detail to this. So we're gonna see Nick fall back, right? So he sits to his butt and then falls to his back. The proper way to execute this is sit to your butt and then fall to your shoulder. Fall this way instead. When you fall back, this is exactly what happens. Your opponent can get to a more advantageous angle for themselves. See, James just kind of scoots off to the side. Even with that underhook in, James is pretty much out of this move by now. But I think if we saw Nick curl to the side and fall to the shoulder instead, that would tighten up that chair sit back take. James says, "All right, my turn. 15 seconds left." Coop and Ben. Everybody just sitting around loafing on a Saturday. James says, "I'm done beating all you guys up. I'm getting out of here." All right, Coop making his way quickly to Ben's back here. Let's see if we could zoom in on this without it going too far off screen. Been doing a good job keeping the legs open here. Nice tripod sweep. Tripod-ish. And now almost in a 50-50 position. Ben looking to switch up to cross. And now instead of using that leg entrance as an attack, looks like he's trying to opt to get to a sweep. Coop, you had the opportunity there, bud, for the triangle. I know you probably see it now, but this is where pull that bottom knee through and then sling it up over the shoulder. Ben maybe caught you there before you could do it, but opportunity was there. Yeah, Coop, if you are searching around in Charleston, if you've never dropped into school before, or you're not sure if you find like there's 10 of them there and you don't know which one to go to, check their schedule, make sure it works for whatever you're doing. If you see things like karate on the schedule, take that off the list. Don't go to that school. Look at their instructors. Look at their lineage. See if there are any affiliates. You could check Tom DeBlass's website. See if there's a Mooresville BJ, or I'm sorry, a Tom DeBlass affiliate there. Ben has made his way into mount now. Some good backstepping and leg control. Shuffle step that foot right into to Cooper's side. And then now pinning that leg so that Cooper can't get his knee in. I'm telling you, buddy, guys, focus on the knees. Knees or ankles, depending on the situation. It makes passing a lot easier. Less movement that you have to do, and less re-guarding you have to deal with. What else do I look for at school? Check the Google reviews. That can be helpful. What else? Yeah, I don't know. Just that they have no gi that is available at the right times, unless you want to bring your gi. So Ben looking for an arm wrap here. Either an arm wrap or a katagatame. Can't tell if he's trying to get his head outside the elbow or if he's just trying to close that distance. Okay, he's climbing the body a bit. Oh, this is tough, Cooper. You're caught. Two arms up. Yep, sitting to S-mount now. I think Ben was actually going for a submission there. So, actually, Gordon did this in like a New Wave training video that came out where he sits to, I think he gets both arms up like this and then sits to like an S-mount position, but then curls his opponent's head up towards him, or his training partner's head, curls it up towards him. It works basically a compression strangle, but from an S-mount instead. And then, you know, videos come out like, oh, new submission? Gordon invents something new? I don't know if it's new or not, but that's definitely the first case, the first instance I've seen of it being used, maybe ever. I don't know. Coop's got that ankle trapped. Let's see if Ben can get that free. Possibly looking for a back take here. I find it hard to do a chair sit back take with the leg trapped. I don't like to do it if I can avoid it. It's a little risky. Ben could be taken off balance in this direction. He could also try to sit the cross ashi if he wasn't so entangled up top. Kids are on the mats. All right, so Ben smashing through. Let's see if he can find the finish here. Yep, and he does. 30 seconds left. This is where I need you to be more diligent, Cooper, just like with the lead up to the competition. I was saying, if your butt touches the mat, you lose, right? I want you to train with that same mentality, man. Even outside of comp. Either way, good stuff. Really great scrambles today. A lot of good repeat moves. I like seeing you guys trying to, either multiple people trying to hit the same thing for whatever reason, or people hitting the same thing across different matches, tightening things up, trying things out, seeing what happens. It's cool. Makes training fun. So thanks for tuning in, guys. I hope you all enjoyed your weekend. I'm looking forward to getting back on the mats tomorrow, so can't wait to see you guys then. I'll probably be pretty tired from my vacation, so look forward to beating me up if you want. I think there's no real new news. There might be an IBJJF coming up in Charlotte in August, so if you guys are interested in that, I mentioned it a few weeks ago, you might want to start looking into that one. No one has expressed an interest in that yet. So if you guys change your mind, change it soon, and let us know. I believe we're going to finish up Side Control this week, so we got one more week of it, I think. Don't hold me to that. And yeah, we should be back on Wednesday, I'm pretty sure. So you guys go, oh wait, follow us here if you're not. There's nobody watching right now. It's the end of a stream on Sunday night. Follow us if you're not. Subscribe if you want. Subscribe at YouTube, all that stuff. And more importantly, go trim your nails and do your laundry. Don't be stinky. And we will see you back on the mats. Take it easy.